Haemophilia is a hereditary bleeding condition. You're born with it. It affects about 1 in 10,000 people. It by and large only affects males. And the common type of haemophilia is called haemophilia A. It's a lack of a clotting factor called factor 8. But there's a second, slightly less common type called haemophilia B. Most of the people have either a lack of factor 8 or factor 9.
Ryan's got severe haemophilia. He has virtually no clotting factor in him at all, so obviously he has the factor 8 to ensure that some clotting can take place.
People with haemophilia don't usually have much of a problem with bruises or if they cut themselves, shaving or something like that. It's not a particular issue. Much more of a problem is bleeding into deep-seated tissues, most particularly joints and muscles. And the characteristic scenario is that you might bang your elbow and you would then bleed into the elbow, which is really very unpleasant and painful. And because the joint is damaged, it's more likely to bleed again.
Growing up, it's not really caused me too many problems. I mean, obviously there's certain things where it's kind of maybe doing that wouldn't be a great idea. But I still do a lot of stuff. I've done a lot of stuff. Have quite a few hobbies.
Obviously, there's certain activities that are more sensible than others. And I
Yeah.
mean, Ryan wanted to try karate, but I think survived about two sessions. And then we just, realised that wouldn't be good. But we still let him try because you've got to know for yourself. And he's got to learn up knowing the kind of risks he can take and the risks he can't take. And, parents aren't there forever. I know you've got to learn for yourself to be responsible for yourself.
A really critical part of care is to have people in the care team who are experts on joints and muscles. So if somebody with haemophilia gets a bleed, we will give the factor 8 to stop the bleeding, and then the physiotherapist will work on the joint or the muscle and get it working again.
I think the biggest problem with growing up with haemophilia is not the bleeding itself, it's the kind of having to manage it, the actual injecting. Because, if I wanted to go away on a school trip, I'd have to make sure I had all the factor I need. It's like the extra, taking responsibility. That's the bigger problem. And I've not been the best for doing that.
Well, for the last 15 years, we've had what we call genetically engineered or recombinant treatment, which doesn't come from any blood donors, but is made in a laboratory in California. So it is human factor 8 and factor 9, but it's genetically engineered. Classically, if somebody has a bleed, we give them an injection of factor 8 and that stops the bleeding, and that's called demand treatment. But in children, it's been shown it's a really good idea to give the injections 3 times a week for haemophilia A, because that stops spontaneous bleeding. A lot of the bleeding in haemophilia will just come out of the blue without any trauma. And the regular giving of factor 8 3 times a week stops that.
There's been times where I had a 6 weeks where I was bleeding really bad into my thigh, and it was so painful. And halfway, but on like the third week, you just get so bored of it. It's like, I just want to get out again. And there's been times where I've been in floods of tears sometimes, not because of pain, just because there's so much you want to do. And sometimes you can't. But you've got to look at things positively, I might not be able to go skiing, but I can still go play basketball with my mates, stuff like that. And there's, you can't let it get you down.
Haemophilia has an unusual inheritance because if you're a man with haemophilia, you can't pass it on to your own sons, but it does mean that your daughters will become carriers. If you are a carrier of haemophilia, your girls, each girl has a 50-50 chance of being a carrier, and each time you have a boy, there's a 50-50 chance of that boy having haemophilia.
I knew I was a carrier because my father has haemophilia, and I was tested to see if I was a carrier, I think in my teens. So I did know that I was, which was soften the blow to start with. And then when Ryan was born, they tested from the umbilical cord. They took blood straight away from the umbilical cord as soon as he was born. And we found out about 3 days later. I mean, obviously, I hoped he wouldn't have, but he did. So here we are.
Our culture and philosophy is very much can do and go out there and do it. And we hardly ever say to anybody, no, you can't. We had somebody wanted to do bungee jumping. We didn't think that was a very good idea. But we're great ones for saying, you know, you can, you can, you can. And, you know, you want to do something, we'll go and do it. And these days, with the treatment being so good, there's no reason why people shouldn't have a really positive outlook on life.